السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. To proceed, today we have the first راوي قالون. The basic rules of the رواية قالون عن نافع، يعني what قالون narrated as a narrator from his شيخ نافع. First we're gonna talk about نافع. نافع المدني يعني from مدينة. He is نافع ابن عبد الله عبد الرحمن ابن أبي نعيم الليثي. Originally from an Isfahanian family. His face was black but was radiant black. يعني like the noor comes out from his mouth, his face. And his mouth was emitting a smell of musk. ما شاء الله. يعني سبحان الله. When his students asked him, do you touch musk every time you sit for recitation? He said, I don't touch any musk. But I saw the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam in a dream reciting the Quran into my mouth. Another dream, he read the Quran to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, and also he said the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam shook his hand. يعني these three things happened with نافع. Then since that time this scent has been coming from him. MashaAllah. Sincere people. He was one of the major scholars of Qira'a or Qira'at during his time. He was born around 70. We're gonna use the number of 70 and 170 and so on to remember this number was him. Yani. He was born around 70 after Hijrah in Medina. And passed away in the same city at age of 99 in 169. For me to remember the number, I make this 70, I make this 170, I make this 100, so on. And it will be easy to remember. He learned the Quran from over 70 successors, tabi'in. يعني his shuyukh, approximately 70. Including Abu Ja'far Yazid ibn al-Qa'qa', who died 130 after Hijrah. This his Shaykh. He was more famous for than his Shaykh. He took his recitation from Abi Huraira, who took his recitation from Ubay ibn Ka'b, who took his recitation from the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam. After the era of the successors, he was taken as the chief qari of Medina, Nafi'. Eventually, his qira'a was adopted by the people of Medina. Among his students was Imam Malik, who died 179 after Hijrah. He used to recite the Quran in Nafi'a's qira'a, saying, indeed, the qira'a of Nafi' is a sunnah, meaning it was the most liked or beloved by him, and it is authentic. The two students who preserved Nafi'a's qira'a reached us. يعني, there is a lot of, if he 70 years listening for the people and teaching the people Quran means he has a lot of students, but the two students who reached us, or Allah chose them to narrate his qira'a, we have Qalun and Warsh. Qalun is Isa ibn Mina ibn Wardan, was born 120, died 220 after Hijrah, means he lived also 100 years. And was nicknamed Abu Musa. يعني his name is Isa and he is Abu Musa. He was the stepson of Nafi'. He was a Roman heritage, of a Roman heritage. and lived in Medina. His Shaykh Imam Nafi' nicknamed him يعني هو سماه قالون, which in the Roman language means good because of the quality of his قراءة. After Nafi' died, he took over his position as the leading qari of Medina and died there. He was deaf and couldn't even hear a horn, but if someone recited the Quran to him, he could hear. Some say the deafness came when he was older, but others mention it as if he was always deaf. And Allah knows best. يعني we're gonna take Qalun's riwaya in details now, inshallah, after we say who was the second rawi from Nafi'. Was his name was Warsh. This is his nicknamed also by Nafi'. He is Abu Sa'id Uthman ibn Sa'id. يعني his name is Uthman between two Sa'id, his father and his son. Al-Misri, he's from Egypt, was born 110, died 197 after Hijra. He lived in Egypt but traveled to Medina in 155 after Hijra to study under Nafi'. You see how the people traveled to take ijaza, and he read it many times, not only once in many years. Studied after Nafi', under Nafi', and they recited the Quran to him many times. Eventually, he returned to Egypt and became the leading qari of Egypt. Alhamdulillah. I was looking for the Qalun Mus'haf to give you the link, but they said we're gonna fix the link and give it to you. Inshallah, I'm gonna put this after I get the link. For you, I will upload the file and give it to you, inshallah. Imam Qalun an Nafi', يعني what Qalun narrated from Nafi'. There is in general 37 basic rules that differ between the 10 Qurra. We have 10 Qari. There is 37 basic rules. يعني we're gonna see what these rules are, which differ between the Qurra. Number one, the Basmala between the two surahs. يعني if he finished this surah and going to continuously reciting the following surah. Some people read the Basmala, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Some people connecting the two surahs without Basmala. Some stop, pause, make sect, and then read the following surah. Then what Qalun is doing, he's doing like Hafs. Qalun has only one way of joining the end of one surah with the next following surah, and that is with the Basmala between the two surahs. The exception would be joining the end of Surah Al-Anfal with the Surah Al-Tawbah, since there is no Basmala at the beginning of Surah Al-Tawbah. This is the exception. He will not put Basmala where there is no Basmala. Just connecting or separating. He has just to connect between the end of Surah Al-Anfal with the Tajweed rules with Bara'ah, the first word in Surah Al-Tawbah, or to pause and then start the Surah. طيب, what he's doing in Surah Al-Fatiha in the word Maliki Yawm al-Din, Qalun reads Malik without Alif in Surah Al-Fatiha, Ayah 4. Some reciting this word like this way, without Alif, the king of the day of resurrection or the day of recompensing. And the others, Malik Yawm al-Din, like Hafs, the owner of the day of judgment. طيب, number three. We're gonna talk about mudud. These are the rules which differ between qari and the other. The mudud means lengthening or prolongation or lengthening. I said lengthening already. extension and so on. قالون reads the واجب متصل مد واجب متصل or obligatory connected مد with four vowel counts like حفص. And the جائز منفصل مد the permitted separated مد with two different allowed lengthening either two shortening it to two which is the preferred one or elongated to four. This is the separated مد المد المنفصل. He has two ways to read it either two short or either four the elongated one. But the two is the preferred. طيب. Now we're gonna talk about the fourth rule. Connecting of meme. Or lengthening or attached meme. Of Dhamma. We make lengthening of the Dhamma into a waw on the plural meme. You see the plural meme here in this ayat. We're gonna read it this way. By putting Dhamma and then elongate the Dhamma into the waw. طيب. Let us read what Kalun is doing. Kalun has two allowed ways of reading the plural meme in a continuous reading when followed by a voweled letter. Why we said voweled letter? Because if it is second, we can't put a letter of mad. We drop it. We're gonna see also this in another ayah after this. طيب. Number A, what are the two allowed ways of reading this meme, plural meme, meme الجمع, the plural meme in a continuous reading when followed by a vowel letter. A, reading the plural meme as it is with a sukun, like Hafs. And this is the preferred for Qalun. Preferred means the first way to read it. And then the second way, like the shortening the separated mad, is the preferred, يعني to read with two counts only, not four, is preferred also. Here, this ayah, you're gonna read it with sukun, is same like Hafs. وَمِنْ آبَائِهِمْ وَذُرِّيَّاتِهِمْ وَإِخْوَانِهِمْ وَجَتَبَيْنَاهُمْ وَهَدَيْنَاهُمْ إِلَى صِرَاطٍ مُسْتَقِيمٍ. طيب, and what is the second way of reciting this ayah? Reading the plural meme by lengthening of a temporary dhamma on the plural meme into a waw of two vowel counts. How he read it? He read it وَمِنْ آبَائِهِمُ وَذُرِّيَّاتِهِمُ وَإِخْوَانِهِمُ وَاجْتَبَيْنَاهُمُ وَهَدَيْنَاهُمُ إِلَى صِرَاطٍ مُسْتَقِيمٍ. But I noticed that this word has a different vowel, not the waw, here waw, here waw. Here well, but here is Hamza. We read them same. No, here if you have a letter of mad followed by Hamza, Hamza al qat'a, which is the disjunctive Hamza, this will be a type of. يعني this will follow the separated mad and mad al munfasil. This mean I could read it two or four, also like he's reading the separated mad. This mean the C. We're gonna read this the third way of Qalun. If there is a disjunctive hamza followed by following the plural meme, then Qalun has three ways of reading, allowable ways of reading this meme. This meme, especially if it has a disjunctive hamza, he will read it in three ways. First way will be the sukun way, the first preferred way for him. The second way, he can put this waw, attach it this waw, with, يعني we pronounce it, into two vowel counts. The third way, elongated to four. Why? Because this follow the separated mat. Let us read. If there is a disjunctive hamza following the plural meme, then Qalun has three allowable ways of reading this meme. Besides the previous A, which is sukun, and B, which is waw, attached waw with two vowel counts, is lengthening two or four vowel counts according with the separated mud length. Here he can read it. وهديناهم إلى صراط مستقيم. صلة ميم الجمع. وهديناهم إلى صراط مستقيم. وهديناهم إلى صراط مستقيم. If we take ورش إن شاء الله you find ورش do same six elongated six. Only the only way for ورش. There is no second. There is no two. It's only six. But here for قالون has three allowable ways. We can do this with this well either with other things which could also be a letter of mad, like the word ana. If you connect it for hafs, he has to drop the alif. If he connect the recitation hafs, he dropped the alif. But what about kalun? Kalun has three ways also in reading this alif. I'm gonna see now. Either drop it when there is any letter other than the disjunctive hamza following ana, and he can keep it and elongate it two or four. This is the three ways. طيب he said notice the same if a disjunctive hamza, hamza dhamma or kasra or fatha. But the kasra has two ways. We either keep the alif, either get rid of the alif. Means he read it with two allowable ways also. But the preferred one to keep the alif. طيب. If a disjunctive hamza with dhamma or fatha or kasra follows the alif of the word ana, this will be a separated mad, of course. After the mad letter, there is a hamzat qata in the following word means this separated mad, as shown in the here, as shown in these examples. Then qalun has three ways of reading this alif. Number one, lengthens it into two or into four vowel counts according to how he is reading the separated mad. If you're reading the ayat with qasr, yani shortening, you have to read it in two only. If you're reading with four, you have to read it in four only. If you have like combinations of meme and the word ana and the hamza, then this means you have to read all the ways, yani this one time and this one time and this one time and so on. طيب. Here the second one to elongate it into four vowel counts according to how he is reading the separated mad. Number three, dropping this alif in two cases. If ana is followed by hamza has a kasra, the second way of reading it, yani this hamza which has kasra, I mean the ana when it's followed by hamza has kasra. One time we keep the alif. The second way is to drop it. Also, we drop this alif, the second case, when beside if the hamza has kasra. The second way, if any other letter is following ana, its alif will be dropped also. Like this, innama ana lakum nadir. Here he will say innama ana lakum nadir. أنا لكم يعني as نون فتحة only. You see this long zero means we keep this alif if we stop on it, but if we connect we drop it. Same like حفص. If any other letter follow أنا we drop it, and if همزة has كسرة follow it, we have two ways. One time we keep it, one time we drop it. الحمد لله. But if the hamza has dhamma or fatha, we keep it. And after we keep it, we deal with it as we deal with the separated mad. Means if he read with two counts, we read it two counts. He read four, we read it four. We can't keep it just like hafs, except if kasra is following it. Hamza with kasra. Hamza with kasra. Here he can read it like this. قال أنا أحيي وأميت وأنا أول المسلمين إن أنا إلا نذير إن أنا إلا نذير Here he can make it long also for any one of them if he's reading with four. But for Warsh, with reading six only, once it's only six, and for the one has kasra, he doesn't elongate it at all. Just if has dhamma or fatha. Inshallah, we talk about Warsh later separately, but I just mentioned sometimes. If the plural meme is followed by a second letter, like in this example, Surah Ali Imran, here, there is no lengthening of the incidental dhamma on the meme due to the meeting of two seconds. يعني لا توجد صلة ميم جمع هنا كما في حفص. منهم المؤمنون. Can I put wow here? No. Why? Because the wow will be mad later ساكن. And also I have lam ساكن. I can't meet two ساكن. I have to get rid of the first one. If it is mad later, I have to drop it. Here. منهم المؤمنون وأكثرهم الفاسقون. Just I put dhamma to get rid of the ميم ساكن itself. The meme itself originally has sukoon. For this reason, I put dhamma. But I can't elongate the dhamma if the following letter is saken. I can elongate it only if it is voweled. For this reason, when we started talking about elongating the meme, the connected meme, we say if it is followed by a voweled letter. A voweled letter, not saken. By this way, you could read it sometime with sukun, sometime with the waw. You could elongate the waw to two or four according to if it has mad hamza after it and so on. But if the followed by second, there is no, none of the readers will elongate this. خلاص, we stopped. طيب, can we take some practice to see how we read? Yes, we could take, we have a practice here. If we have a combination of the plural meme and the separated mad, then in the ayah, then Qalun has four allowable ways of reading this ayah. How? Two for the meme. He can read it one time second, one time with waw, with connection. Multiply by two. For mad, this mean we will have four ways are arranged. How we arrange these four ways? He said arrange it according to which one came first. The one came first, what will happen? Even if it is repeated many times in the ayah, we just take the first one, we deal with it, and the others will follow the same rule. Type the one came first, what will happen? It will have to change status only once. What means status? Means if it is meme, came first, will be meme second in the first one. And the second still will not change now. While the separated mad will change, like from shortened to lengthening, two to four. And then the meme will change only once. Connected meme will stay connected. This means the one came first, here meme came first, will change the status only once, while the other will change thrice in the four ways. One time shorten, one time lengthening, one time shorten, one time lengthening means the first was shortened and then start to change here and change again and change again. But the meme only changed once. Why? Because the meme came first. طب, if I have the opposite, if I have the mad came first, we will have same. The mad will stay constant and change only in the third one. Here. If the mad came first, the mad came first. The mad will stay shorten, and will change only once and will stay like this. But for the meme will be sukoon, connection. Maybe I talk fast. I'm gonna repeat this one more time in more explanation, inshallah. We are talking about if we have a combination in the ayah, not only meme, jam'a. We have meme and separated mad. if he reads the meme with two ways and the separated mod with two ways, this means I will have 2 multiplied by 2 will give me 4 ways. The arrangement of these 4 ways depending upon which one came first will change only once. Then the other one will change thrice. By this way, I will know what I'm gonna do if I read it. Like for example, this ayah. الذين إذا ذكر الله وجلت قلوبهم والصابرين على ما أصابهم. By this way, I read it. ميم ساكن and قصر shortening. يبقى I made سكون ميم shorten separated mad means I read it 2 counts on. طيب the following I change from the back. I always change from the end of the ayah or the back of the ayah. When I come back, I will change here. I will not change this one until I finish changing here. I will say this next time. على ما أصابهم. This means this will stay like this with سكون. I didn't change it, and I went to the mad. I changed it, lengthened it into 4. Type. The third step. I have to change here once, only once here in the third one. I will make connection. You see, it was second, but this was 2 and then 4. But now, after I connected, I put Dhamma, I connected into Waw, then connected Mim. First, I read the Mad with shortening, and next time, this will stay as it is connected, and I will make the separated Mad 4 elongated into or lengthening it. Into 4 separated. Okay. Also, we have the same 4 allowable ways if the plural meme or the word ana is followed by with a disjunctive hamza will be also mad munfasil. Huh? Let us see how we're gonna arrange this. Tusiruna ilayhim meme jam'a came first means will it change only once. Which is the third step. بالمودة وأنا أعلم. Here أنا has همزة after it. Will be following the separated mad. Same. What you doing هنا, you doing here. Okay. وأنا أعلم بما أخفيتم. Here. The first step will be ميم ساكن and shortening. 2 and 2. Same. Whatever was written here. The first one. ميم ساكن and shortening separated mad 2. This is also following separated mad. Same. 2 here, 2 here. طيب, the second way, you have to come from the back and change the end. At the end. Means I will read this with 4 and this with 4. And this will stay as it is. Same. Sukun mim, lengthening separated mad. طيب, the third way, I have to give chance for the mim to change now. I put the sila, connection. Attach it with waw, and then I read with قصر shortening here. Only 2, and the fourth one, same. I leave this as with the connection. I didn't change it. I go here and elongate it 4 and 4. Okay, let us switch. See if we have the opposite. أخذين ما آتاهم ربهم إنهم كانوا قبل ذلك محسنين. طيب, what we gonna read here, the mad came first, means the mad will stay on قصر, shortening the 2 first one, shorten, and will change only from the third one, and will stay on the, like it, on the fourth one. طيب, what about the meme? This meme has hamza after it, means we'll deal with it, same like mad منفصل. First, we read it with سكون. سكون ميم. Second, we put connection 2 and the mad still 2. طيب, the third one, I make the mad itself 4 and I make the ميم ساكن again because the ميم it has to be one time سكون, one time connection, one time سكون, one time connection, like I did here for the mad, the opposite here for the mad here. One time shorten, one time lengthen, one time shorten, one time length. يبقى change thrice. سمسم here for the ميم because the ميم came after. سكون connection سكون connection. طيب after I made سكون for the ميم with the shortened separated mad. Connection for the ميم for the shortened. And then سكون for the ميم for the separate long lengthening one. Also I give a connection for the ميم for the connected ميم. Lengthening. If I lengthen this four, also the connected ميم I length it four. But what the one who, about the one which doesn't have hamza after it? This I can't elongate it more than two. Okay, this is two and this is two, but this is four because it's followed by hamza. This will follow the separated mad. Inshallah, easy. And the two lesson to Kalun, Kalun's recitation with all of these allowable ways and more, you could listen for the Shaykh on this link. He reads the whole Quran with the four ways according which one came first. He read the ayah with the same arrangement rules. Alhamdulillah, the whole Quran. May Allah reward him. Okay, now I have another combination I added. If we have a plural meme, the word ana is followed with a disjunctive hamza has a kasra. If the hamza itself has a kasra, this mean we will have two ways of reading it. Beside we reading the as a mad, will follow the mad here, the separated mad. Also the hamza itself, one time we drop it, one time we keep I mean the alif, one time we drop it, one time we keep it. This mean we will have two and two and two will be eight. Let us see. وما أدري ما يفعل بي ولا بكم إن أتبع إلا ما يوحى إلي وما أنا إلا نذير مبين. The changes start from the left, as I told you, from the end of the ayah, not from the beginning of the ayah. From the left side, the end of the verse, step by step, and goes towards the right, the beginning. Huh? This means if we change, we change the mad munfasil, the separated mad first, or we change the meem? We change the meem, because the mad came first, and then the meem. Type. What about this? This also separated mad means it will follow the first one. Then I don't have to pay attention to this because whatever I do here, I will do it here automatic. But what about wama ana? Here wama ana also is a separated mad. What about here ana, the alif of ana and the hamza? Here what we have to do, one time we keep the alif of ana, one time we drop it. And when we keep it, it will follow the separated mad. One time two, one time four. And this means we read it with three ways. Let us see how we're going to start the combinations. The mad came first means we're going to change it. Not on the third one this time, will be the fifth one. Why the fifth? Because it was only we have four ways of reciting the ayah, but now we have eight. When we have eight, this means we doubled the ways, the steps or the ways, the methods which we read the ayah with it, doubled. Because we have eight ways of reading. Every time we have either keep the alif or drop it, keep the alif or drop it, keep the this means ana will be repeated with me all the way. First time we shorten the separated mad and we keep the meme second. This is the first, has to be the first because this is the preferred for Qalun to make the mad. This means the first way we have to make shorten here, shorten separated mad and second meme and lengthen the alif, means we keep this alif, yani we keep this alif of ana, two vowel counts. I keep the alif because he read the one which follows with kasra, hamza with kasra, into two ways. The preferred one to keep the alif, this means I keep the alif. If I keep the alif, I have the English one. if I keep the alif means I don't know what's wrong. عايزة اشيل الصفر المستدير ده. ايوه الحمد لله راح مستطيل. مشكلة يعني there is a problem if I write English with Arabic I will have a lot of troubles. Sometimes this jump right jump left it bothers me all the time. I don't know how to deal with it. Anyway. The first one I will keep Anna. Alhamdulillah. Alif of Anna I keep it. And it will be two counts. The normal mad. Type. The second one I keep the mad as it is. Shorten. Imagine we it was we keep shorten two only and then we start to change in the third. Now we keep it shorten four. And we keep it lengthening four. You see the first one came. It will change in the fifth step. Four shorten, four lengthening. Okay. Let us go to the meme. How we deal with the meme? The meme will have two sukun, two connection. Two sukun, two connection. Two sukun, two connection. Huh? طيب, what about أنا? One time I keep it, one time I drop it. One time I keep it. بس I have to fix this like this one إن شاء الله after I finish I will do it because I have timing in in the video. I can't keep doing this twist time. Oh. سبحان الله. Doesn't want it to be deleted. طب cut. It's insist. طيب let us do the ayah. Now we know what we're gonna do. We have why we have eight type. If we have four shorten, four lengthening, and the sukun sukun. Connection, connection. Because one time we keep Anna, one time we drop the alif. One time we keep the alif, one time we drop it. The two, one time we keep it, one time we drop it with second meme. And one time we keep it, one time we drop it with connected meme. And also we have the same here. One time we keep it, one time we drop it. But when we keep it, we elongate it four this time. With second meme and with connected meme because we have here also the lengthening one. Remember the separated mad will be lengthening here. Also alif ana also will be four. This will be four, this will be four. And then I drop it with second meme and the connected meme. For this reason it's eight. Inshallah, you listen for the Shaykh while he's reciting. You will understand everything. And if you have any questions, just write for me your questions. Here, the third way, Qalun could have, there is another combination. Qalun could have the same eight allowable ways of reading the verse if we have in the combination instead of the word Ana. Two different vowels, hamzas of two adjacent words. But we didn't take the hamzat yet. For this reason, I sometimes take something up, then something down. The hamzas will come after this. I didn't talk about them yet. But anyway, I discover it now only. The first hamza has dhamma. Let us see. If the first hamza has dhamma and the second hamza has kasra. Okay, qalun changes or alters the second hamza into a waw and soften it also. يعني he read it by two allowable ways. One time he changed it into a wow, يعني instead يشاء إلى he say يشاء ولا will be wow. And the second way softening it, يعني don't read it like يشاء إلى, no he will say يشاء يشاء إلى إلى إلى, يعني to soften the همزة, يعني read it between the همزة and the letter of مد which is look like the same vowel. Here the همزة has كسرة, يعني between the همزة and ياء, he will soften the همزة between the همزة and ياء, will say يشاء إلى إلى. طيب mean he will read it by two ways, the same like we kept the alif and drop the alif, will be eight also, two for the meme sukun and sila connection, two for the mad shortening and elongating, two for the two hamzas which has dhamma and kasra, one changing it into wow and one is softening it, will be eight ways. And here is the ayah, ومنهم من يمشي على أربع يخلق الله ما يشاء إن الله على كل شيء قدير. He will read it the eight ways we mentioned. طيب also what time we will have six? If we have two ways on we are not allowed to do them, يعني forbidden, the eight will be six. Kalun could have six allowable ways of reading the verse if the combination includes two identical adjacent hamzas in two words. Also this I didn't talk about it, but inshallah we talk about it in the following video. Inshallah will be easy for you after you listen. If I have the two adjacent hamza, they have the same vowels, kasra and kasra, kasra and kasra, dhamma and dhamma, how Kalun will read it, will come to the first one and make it easy, soft. And he read it with one time mad 4, one time with mad 2. Elongation will be 4 and 2. The 4 is preferable because we still have يعني a trace of the hamza, even we softening it, but still two identical adjacent hamzas in two words have dhammas or kasra, يعني in two words and they have كسرة or dhamma. Kalun soften the first hamza accordingly, reads the two words with two allowable ways of lengthening, the first which is the preferred, four beats mad and then two as in the separated mad. يعني as he reads the separated mad, he will if he reads with two, he will read the two ways. But if he read it with four, he will read only the four. And the shortening of the lengthening to two vowel counts relating to the changed hamza, such as here with the plural meme, and the separated mad with us with these two hamzas. If we have the combination has hamzas and the meme and separated mad, we will have two by two by two will be eight. We notice that he said the preferred one to elongate because this was the attached mad, the connected mad was four originally. This means if you soften this hamza, you read four first and then two. Also here, four first, then two. Also here, four first, then two. Some scholars forbade to shorten a soften obligatory connected mad when you have a lengthening four beats permitted separated mad. This means, he said, if you read this with two ways, one time four, one time two, and you have two ways of reading this separated mad, one time two, one time four, if you read this two, you could read this one time four, one time two. But if you read this four, the separated mad, which is weaker than the connected mud, even if it is changed one. You can't make this less than the connected mud is stronger than the separated mud. This means I can't make the weak one 4 and make this 2. I have to make it only 4. This is what the scholar said. Some of them forbid to shorten a soften, even if it is soften. Obligatory connected mud when you have a lengthening 4 beats permitted separated mud with 4 vowel counts. This why Qalun reads it in 6 instead of 8. 6 allowable ways instead of 8, as in we have 8 minus the 2 forbidden one will give you 6. We have here the ayah. وَيَوْمَ يَحْشُرُهُمْ جَمِيعًا ثُمَّ يَقُولُ لِلْمَلَائِكَةِ أَهَؤُلَاءِ إِيَّاكُمْ كَانُوا يَعْبُدُونَ. First I elongate this. When I soften this, I elongate it 4 and then I read it 2. When I read this 2, I could get here 4 and 2. But he said if you make this 4, you can't get the 2 here. Just get the 4 one. You might refer to these combinations when we talk about the word At-Tawrah. As Qalun reads it also with 2 ways. One is like halves, like At-Tawrah, opening the alif like this. And the other is like Warsh with a minor deflection. You need to take the alif down while you pronounce it. You say At-Tawrah. If we have also a plural meme, and a separated mad, we will have 2 and 2 and 2. With Torah, we'll have 8 ways. But there is 3 forbidden ways of recitation from the 8 ways. This means I can't read 8. I only read 5 allowable ways. These 3 forbidden ways, which are which one are forbidden? When you make sukun for the meme and the shorten separated mad, and you are not allowed to open the Torah like halves. You have to make a deflection. Yani you make it a Torah with the sukun of the meme and the shortening of the separated mad. Also, there is 2 more forbidden ways. When you connect the meme, both the 2 and the 3 in the connected meme, one of the shortening separating mud and one in the lengthening separated mud. What is forbidden here to make the deflection? You have to read it at Torah. Yibqa, the connected meme, shortening separated mud. The forbidden is to read the Torah with minor deflection. Means you have to read it at Torah with Fath. And also the opposite here. With the lengthening separated mud, read the Torah with a minor deflection, which is forbidden. Qalun has only one word. Qalun reads only one word with the major deflection. Which is hair, yani, like the deflection here will be between the alif and between the ya, like 45 degrees. If we have the alif up vertically, like the line, vertical line, and the ya is horizontally, this means the deflection will be 45 degrees between the alif and the ya. Means major deflection. Yani you say hair, but for Torah we say at-Torah only. Yani is closer to the alif. This is the minor one, but the major one is only one word, and also is one word for the minor deflection for Qalun. He doesn't have a lot of deflection, only 2 words. After that, we're gonna talk inshallah next time about كناية ها or the pronoun of direct object ها ضمير للكناية إن شاء الله next time. سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك أشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت أستغفرك وأتوب إليك. my Skype is Mama loves Quran. Put dots between loves and the Quran if you like to, if you have any question, inshallah. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah.